actually people were sitting on the floor, people were seeing, actually getting in there, the stink of urine in front of the emergency room is ridiculous. The doctors have no hand sanitizer. Infection control is a big deal. People are sick. Immune, they already have problems. Now, a doctor comes in and there's no hand sanitizer on their table. Patients have to buy their own gloves, buy their alcohol, which is methylated spirit, I guess they call here, in wool, cotton wool, to actually get treated. Doctors start an IV, pull the IV out, you don't get it, they use the same needle to start somewhere else. That is infection control. Nobody is talking about that. Actually, some diseases can actually be, you might not have it if you take care of those things. Hand sanitizer, I've been in this country in the past week, I've been everywhere. I have not seen a single place where I go and there's a hand sanitizer. We should have it on the tables, in the restaurants. In the United States, everybody knows the drill. You'll have it there. I mean, they don't force you to use it, but you'll have it there. But here, it's not even, no one is thinking about it. Like, you could use a hand sanitizer, you're gonna go to the restaurant, and you're gonna eat, and you don't have anything. You just dip your hands in the fork, in the food. You understand? Even the staff, I mean, I had to talk to the doctor. The doctor was very knowledgeable, but professionalism was zero. People were in slippers at the medical, doctors were wearing flip-flops.
Are you kidding me?
And the place, the dirt, hospitals are supposed to help you. I mean, it harbors a whole lot of germs. Mm. So there should be a temperature which the hospital should be in.
Tell us about it.
But we don't have it. We don't even, the doors are open, mosquitoes. I actually made a video of a pharmacy people. I don't know if she's actually the pharmacy, but there were three people in the pharmacy and we went in to get medication. They locked the door, put a mattress on the floor, and we're sleeping on duty. People are sick in the emergency room, and the pharmacy brought a mattress. Oh, wow. I couldn't hold myself. I said, this is ridiculous.
So what did you do?
Oh, I took a video. I spoke to her. You can't. She actually ignored me. She didn't even move.
Can you tell us exactly where it is you're talking about?
Oh, I'm talking about General Hospital, Ayike. Hospital. We were there like 3 days ago. It was about 108. I made a video.
Yes.
And I saw patients, people, families sleeping on the floor. Patients had no bed. I saw someone and she had edema all over, I think it's a kidney disease. Mm. And she was sitting waiting for a bed. Nothing was done. Mm. My nephew went in, he had a crisis, a sickle cell, and had a crisis. Mm. We had to sit on the chair to get infusion. We hold the bag up. Come on. I mean, this is where we're supposed to go to for succor, for help. For teaching, doctors don't teach you what you're doing. They don't even know, patients don't know what they have. Some don't know what they have, so they don't even know what to do. Pharmacists don't tell you, this is the medication you're getting, this is a side effect. Nobody asks if you have any allergies. Oh my God, it is a disaster.
Huge disaster, that is what some other persons will truly call it.
Yes.
Now that you've talked about that Ayike house, of course I'm looking at this report, April 24, 2019, from Premium Times, where President Muhammadu Buhari inaugurated the Institute of Maternal and Child Health, Ayike House.